Today I'm in an attic in Maryland and we're doing a few things around here. We're putting in baffles, as you can see behind me.
I'm going to show you how they're installed, how they function, their purpose, and the formula you need to figure out how much net-free ventilation area you need in your house. Before we add insulation to get this attic up to today's standard, we always start by installing baffles. These lightweight plastic channels help maintain a pathway for air to flow from the soffit vents into the attic. Without them, your insulation can block the overhang, not allowing the air to get through. It might lead to trapped moisture in the attic and reduce the effectiveness of your attic's overall ventilation system. We place the baffle between the rafters and staple it to the roof deck. The goal is to create a clear path for air to flow above the insulation and up towards the ridge vent. The soffit is the intake and the ridge vent is the exhaust. We're careful to block airflow around the baffle to reduce wind washing, which can occur if the circumstances are right. One thing you need to know to determine how much net free ventilation area you need for your house is to know whether or not you have a vapor retarder. The first tip to see if you might have one without even having to go into the attic is to determine what climate zone you're in. Generally, using a vapor retarder, sometimes also known as a vapor barrier, depends on your climate zone specifically, how cold your winters are, and how likely it is that indoor moisture will migrate into the colder parts of your building envelope and condense. The final confirmation should be a quick peek in the attic. The two most common ways to create a vapor retarder is the use of sturdy plastic installed before the ceiling's up. Most common, however, of the two is using fiberglass bats with craft paper. But don't be lulled to sleep by this for those in colder climates. Unless they're installed to perfection, moisture will flow around them pretty much every time. If you don't have a vapor retarder, the ratio of net free airspace you need is 1 square foot of space for every 150 feet of attic area. Be sure to account for anything that's blocking the air's route, including louvers and screens. Combine the soffit intake and the ridge vent exhaust. At least 40% of your net free space should be intake from down low, the soffit. But it could also be from a special vent installed into the roof like you see here. Usually houses that don't have an overhang feature are good candidates for this type of product. If you have gable vents, leave those out of your totals. If you get your net free airflow space nailed down, you can block them off to improve the airflow dynamics. If your home has a vapor retarder, the net free space is reduced to 1 square foot for every 300 square feet. So if you have bats, they're probably not really working, as I mentioned, so stick with the 1 to 150 ratio if that's what you have going on in your attic. Now that the baffles are in place and sealed off, we're ready to blow the insulation in. So many of my customers ask if improving attic ventilation is going to help with their comfort, especially in the summer. Well, it's not going to hurt, but don't do it as a standalone project and expect big results. Be sure to air seal, raise your R value up to today's standards for your region, and that's when you're going to start to feel a real difference. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, you found it helpful, subscribe to my channel at Home Air Leakage Test. Thank you.